Hey guys, it's Will from EDM Tips doing something a little bit different this week. I've got lots of requests from you guys asking, how do I pick apart and analyze the music that I recreate in my In the Style of Lessons? So I'm going to show you everything you need to know to pick apart a track in the style that you love, so you can then create something in that genre of music and not miss anything out. If you're new to this channel, each week I share electronic music production tips. So whether you produce techno, house, trance, drum and bass, doesn't matter, I share with you pro tips to help you up your music production game. So if that sounds good to you, click subscribe and hit that notification bell to make sure you never miss a video. Now, referencing is a super important skill. It's kind of like a blueprint for success because you can work out how your beats should be made, you can work out how your chords should be made, you can work out what your mixes should sound like, and this is one of the key skills that you have to learn if you want to truly get to a professional standard of music production. Even the best producers in the world still reference other people's music to get ideas for composition, mixing, mastering, and everything else in the music production process. If you do want more in-depth coaching and feedback on your music each and every week, then check out my 8-week EDM production masterclass below. Anyway, without further ado, let's hop into the door and I'm going to show you exactly how I pick apart and analyze a reference track to use in my own productions.
The first thing I do is I'd open up a blank project in whatever DAW I'm using, so I'm using Ableton, drag in the MP3 or the WAV, wherever you've downloaded it from, and it's easier to reference things if you have downloaded the file rather than just streaming it, so you can do what I'm about to show you. Okay, so now we need to work out what the tempo of this track is. So the easiest way to do that is go to the first transient and make sure that your clip starts from the first transient, which would usually be the first kick on the downbeat. We could do it from here, but I'm going to assume that your track might have a bit of a smoother intro, so I'll show you what I would do in that instance. So I would go to the first kick, which would be here. Make sure it's right on it. Okay, now how I would work out the tempo of this track, I'd probably just do a Google search. So Google search tempo, Martin Garrix, Feeling Khalid, Ocean, David Guetta remix, you'll find the tempo. But if you can't for whatever reason, I'm going to show you how I work it out. I put the metronome on and then I do it by ear like a DJ. So I can hear that the tempo's too short, too slow on the project. And another quick tip, you can actually see how it lines up with the grid as well, and that gives you a clue. So if we do that, we can see it's probably 127. Let's look where the drops hit. And you can hear. So that's now correct, we've got the right tempo, and the reason we do that is because it's easier to loop particular sections and then to analyze them, break them down. So first thing to do is realize that there are usually three sections to a track. Yeah, usually. So you'll have the main drop, you'll have the verse sections, and you'll have the break sections. Sometimes there might be one or two others, but that's generally what you'll find, especially in most modern popular electronic dance music. So I would go to the final drop usually and analyze that first. Okay, so let's just loop 8 bars there, 4 bars. So everything that's going on in the track really is all coming together in this final drop, and that's why I suggest analyzing these first. So, okay, let's break down what's going on in the track. Okay, so you've got the kick on every beat because it's a house tune, and then you've got the clap on every other beat. Kick, clap, kick, clap. So it's easiest to break down, I guess, the beats first if that's what you want to do. Then you've got the open hat in between each kick. But oh, what's that? You can hear there's a little skip as well happening with a snare. So, You can hear this little snare kind of, there's like a little skip. So that's something to note. They're using skipping snares to kind of keep the groove going. And there's a bit of swing to this track as well. There's a bit of a groove template, so it's slightly off the grid. So it's not going ta ta ta, it's more like ta ta ta. So there's a single skip there, then there's a double skip there, there's a single skip there, then a double skip there. Okay, so that's kind of the beat. There's also a shuffle, like a tambourine going on in the background as well. Kind of quietly. And that's really getting that groove going. Then the next main thing to work out is the chords of the piano. So I would work out what the bass notes of each chord are and then build out the chords from there. So you can hit dum, 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 dum. And then you've got the bass line and you've got the vocal. They're the main parts of the track. But listening carefully to every tiny detail is where the magic lies. And if there's a lot going on, this is when you can skip to another part of the track and you might learn some new nuances that you couldn't hear when everything's happening, because it's a lot for your ear to decipher. Oh, a quick tip. If you're trying to work out what's going on in the low end, you can throw a filter on it, on the track, and just roll off the high end, and then you've just got the kick and the bass. So it's a nice way to hear what the bass rhythm is doing. Dum, dum, bum, ba, bum, ba, bum, ba, bum. And also what notes it's hitting. So that's another way to kind of break it down and make it easier for your ears to decipher what's going on. So let's go back to, okay, so we can see if we now drag this forwards, because we set the beat to happen, we set the grid from the first transient, which was the beat. Now we can kind of extend it back out. Okay, I'm just going to cut off that first part and just drag it back. So it's bang on the beat still. So for instance, it would be easier to determine what the chords are here because there's less going on. And you can actually hear that tambourine really easily here. And you can hear the vocal kind of being introduced and delaying left and right. And there's a filter going on underneath it. And here you can actually hear there is a like a synth underneath this, like a very quiet arpeggio going. And underneath this vocal here, you can hear there's another vocal layered underneath, like one octave down, a deep vocal. Just this bit. Oh. You can hear underneath the main vocal. And that's being used just to enhance that one word by having a very quiet layer underneath it, dropped an octave down. So this is the kind of nuance and detail you really need to kind of train your ears to hear. And it does take practice, and with more practice, you'll pick it up. But if you want to produce truly professional sounding music, then this is the attention to detail that you'll need to develop. So here, there's like a boom and the huh. And then there's a reverse reverb into the next vocal. Yeah.
Show me why you're crying.
And if you want to learn about reverse reverb, you can watch the video that I'll link to here.
Show me why you're crying for. I'll wipe your tears on.
Okay.
If
so
you're
the chord progression switched up here, different
love, we'll come for you for.
So you'd have to, well, you don't have to work out the exact chord progressions, but it's just something to be aware of that this is where you might switch up the chord progression slightly in the tune. But it's quite unusual.
Tell me what you're crying for. I'll wipe your tears on. If you're so taking love.
And you can hear the strings come in there. So here you've just got the organ and the vocal and the subdued kick, which is quieter. And it's just the bass frequencies of the kick, so he's filtered out the top frequencies.
Tell me what you're crying for. I'll wipe your tears on.
And now strings.
If you're so taking love, we'll come for you for sure. When my head goes in every direction, you know my walls never.
The bass line's coming in now, but with the low end filtered out. Introducing it, lasers, snare roll, bassline coming in. Full beats there. So yeah, spend the time to break down each of these sections, and the more you can ascertain what's going on, the better your music will be able to be, because you'll then be able to understand how it's put together. So yeah, I hope you found this helpful. Do spend the time, you know, it might take an hour, 2 hours to break down a track properly. But as I said, the more you do it, the better you're going to get and the easier it's going to be next time. So there you go, guys. I really hope you enjoyed this and found it insightful. If you did, please smash like and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And once again, if you do want to find out more about how to get in-depth coaching and feedback, you can click the link below. Thank you so much for watching, and until next time, cheers and happy producing.
Tell me what you're crying for.